faithful. Oh, come all ye faithful. Oh, come all ye faithful to Bethlehem. Oh, 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 come all ye faithful. Oh, come all ye faithful. Oh, come all ye faithful to Bethlehem. We welcome you to this special episode of Let's Worship. And to start with, we just want to say Merry Christmas. We hope that you're having a great time with family and friends. But this is a time just not to celebrate, but to think about that great sacrifice that the Father did for us by sending His own Son, His only begotten Son, for whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And that's the joy of Christmas. And I hope that we would be part of your half hour today and to sing some beautiful songs that portray the birth of Jesus Christ. And what a joy it is to be celebrating the birthday of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let's do this together.
Yeah. Let's adore him. Let's worship him. A king is born for us today. I think the greatest news that heaven ever sent to mankind was the news that Jesus was born. Christ was born as one eternal sacrifice for all of our sins. Yet whoever looks upon him will never be shamed, and their faces are brightened. And we have a Father who we can call him Abba Father through the blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus came as that sacrifice and bridged that gap that we had with the Father. So today we can boldly enter into the most holy place through that blood of Jesus Christ. And that's the most joyful news that man ever heard. And let's spread that news again. Joy to the world. Was born not just as a lamb but as a king. Every single person that came to see the newborn Savior, one question that rose in each of their minds was, what child is this? What an awesome child is born. The wise men, the shepherds, and even Mother Mary, all of them had this question, what child is this? He was not this normal kid. He was born to save mankind. And whoever believes in him are saved. Child is this. It was given for us, though we never deserved it. He never needed to come as well, but he chose to come down to take our place. And even as we sing songs of Christmas, sing songs about the birth of Christ, I just want to talk about the need for mankind to acknowledge that love that was shown on that day in Bethlehem. Christ chose the most lowliest place to be born to make sure that the sacrifice and the relationship that God wanted to build was not for the rich, is not for those who can afford a sacrifice as how it was during the Old Testament. But God chose to be born in a manger, in a stable, so that you and I, no matter who you are, no matter what situation you are in, no matter what position of life you are in, no matter what standard of living you live, Christ's love is universal. It is for all of us. And that's why we read in John 3:16, for God so loved the world. I love that word, the verse when it starts with saying, for God. So this arrangement was not man-made, it was God-made. God prepared this for man. God made sure that man could still find a place back into his house. When God kicked out Adam and Eve out of the Garden of Eden, I'm sure that everyone thought that was the end of the relationship that God wanted to create with man. But God, through the ages, He kept on showing His love, and He wanted somehow to connect with mankind again. And sometimes I don't even understand, why would God do that? Why would He need man to be up there in heaven with Him? Though we may not understand that, but it's the fact that Christ came down to this world because God so loved the world. And I think the word "so" has no end. That's how much God loved. I think that's one time when even God did not know how to express the magnitude of His love for humankind. He couldn't just put a word to explain how much. He just said "so." He just said, God so loved the world. There's no limit, there's no boundaries for that love. And if you're watching this program and you're wondering what we are doing right here, I just want to tell you that Jesus is the way. He's not one of the ways. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Without Him, no man can come to the Father. Because Christ came just for you and I. And this is exactly what the angel spoke on that day. This is what the shepherds praised on that day. This is exactly what the wise men wanted to see that day. Let's sing along with the angels and glorify our Father in heaven.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strain. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
We worship you, King. Though you were born a child, you weren't born as a prince, you were born as a king. I think the first time there was a child that was born, and he was born as a king. Even if a child is born in a palace, even if a child is born to the greatest king ever who lived, he would only be born as a prince. But there was this one child who was born as a king, and we are here to worship him. And he was born holy, so we could be like him as well. And there's one thing that I love about God, is there's no one who could take that name of calling himself the Holy One. Christ was born for us to save our sins, and for that to happen, he has to be holy. And he was born as a holy Savior. And that's why we sing this song.
Holy, holy, are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb, for you are.
Kings, we worship you. We worship you because you alone are worthy of our praise. Every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Thank you for tuning with us this beautiful day. And we just want to wish a Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year that's about to follow. That's all from all of us here. And I'm Joel and Rohit, and this is Nina saying Merry Christmas again. God bless you.